One day in 1937, I had a meeting with Herr von Ribbentrop, German ambassador to Britain. In one of my fortnightly articles, I noted that he had been misrepresented in some speech he had made. I had, of course, met him several times in society. He now asked me whether I would come to see him and have a talk. He received me in the large upstairs room at the German embassy. We had a conversation lasting for more than 2 hours. Ribbentrop was most polite, and we ranged over the European scene, both in respect of armaments and policy. The gist of his statement to me was that Germany sought the friendship of England, on the continent we are still often called England. He said he could have been Foreign Minister of Germany, but he had asked Hitler to let him come over to London in order to make the full case for an Anglo-German entente or even alliance. Germany would stand guard for the British Empire with all its greatness and extent. They might ask for the return of the German colonies, but this was evidently not cardinal. What was required was that Britain should give Germany a free hand in the east of Europe. She must have her Lebensraum, or living space, for her increasing population. Therefore, Poland and the Danzig corridor must be absorbed. White Russia and the Ukraine were indispensable to the future life of the German Reich, of more than 70 million souls.